Yo, what's good, fam? In the last video, we got our bootstrap all set up. We got our player connecting with ease. And in this video, we're going to be spawning the player prefab. So before we jump into it, please drop me a like. It helps so much. And subscribe if you want some more juicy content. Let's do this. So now it's time to get a character in here. So let's create a capsule. Call him Spooky Boy. Because he's spooky. And we're going to want to add a ghost authoring component. Just to make him a little more spooky. But what that does is actually allow it to sync across the server. So for our ghost, we're going to support predicted, and we're going to have a has owner attribute, which allows the support auto command target. And let's save our spooky boy as a prefab here. And we crashed. So we're back up after the crash. We have our spooky boy. Let's go into our netcode. Let's create a component. We'll call it spooky boy. And then a mono component, we'll call it Spooky Boy Mono, and that'll get it extra spicy. First, let's edit our Spooky Boy. It's a struct, iComponent data, you know the drill. And we could leave it like this, but just to show you there are ways to sync variables across netcode, you would just, you know, create a variable, so let's say public int spooky level. And this is basically just the measure of how scared people get when they see our Spooky Boy. But the spooks aren't over yet. See, in order to sync this over the network, we actually have to add a ghost field attribute. And that'll let the server and the client both know that we're spooked. We're synced up, we're ready to go. They'll both know the value of spooky level. And so let's open our spooky boy mono. Here, it's really simple. Delete all that, keep that. And so we need the int, right? So we're gonna get our public int and we're gonna say spooky level. And now we're gonna create a baker, so public class, Spooky Boy Baker. Spooky Baker is good. We're going to do Baker, Spooky Boy Mono. And there we go. Make sure you have Unity for entities because that is the only way you're going to bake this stuff. And so now we got to bake this baby at 350 for 10 minutes. So let's implement our abstract class. Let's get our baking. And basically, we're just going to add our components. So let's say Spooky Boy. Spooky Boy is a new Spooky Boy. But instead of these, we're just going to say spooky level is equal to authoring.spooky level and set it at that. And now we'll just add this component to our guy. So there we go. And so now we have our hero, and let's get him on the battlefield. We're going to create another component. We'll call it spawner and a mono to go along with it, spawner mono. So let's open up spawner. And in there, it's a struct iComponent data. And we need a entity to track. So we're gonna do public entity, the boy who lived. There we go. And now let's open up our spawner mono and let's get a prefab reference there. So we want our prefab, we'll call this one the scariest boy in town. There we go. And so now we gotta bake our guy. So let's do public class spawner baker. And that's a baker of our spawner mono. There we go. Implement that abstract class. And so since we have a game object, we have turned to an entity. Let's create a default layout of our spawner. Yes, that's what I wanted. There we go. And now let's just set the boy who lived to be our entity of our scariest boy in town. Oh, we need our authoring. And there we go. And now let's just add this component to our entity. There we go. So we have our spawner, but we have to do a couple things to actually get him to spawn, right? So let's do a state.require for update. And we'll put our spawner. So our client's all set up. Now we have to actually do the same thing to our server. So let's get this require for update spawner in the server. And now in the server, we're actually going to update. So we're going to get our prefab, which is our entity prefab. And we're going to get system API dot get singleton, and we're going to get our spawner, and we're going to get our boy who lived, and that's our entity right here. Then we're actually going to have to instantiate our prefab, so let's say our player, and we'll get from our command buffer, and we'll instantiate from there. So we'll instantiate our prefab, and then we'll set the component in the command buffer to our prefab, so let's say set component player, and we're going to get it a new ghost owner component, and set the network ID. We're actually going to have to delete our connection once we, you know, disconnect, right? So if the server knows that we're not there anymore, So to do that, we're going to append to our buffer, to our request source connection, and we're going to create a new linked entity group, which is basically going to say, hey, delete this player when this connection ends, right? That's really all it is. And with that, we should be able to see our player get created, right? So let's go back. I've had this issue before. Did I save? Yes. Okay. I've had this issue before where it wasn't at 000, so check that out, because when it spawns, it will spawn wherever you put this position. I mean, we could change it, but it's outside the scope of this. So what we're going to want to do is create a spawner. Let's call this spawner, add it to our shared world, and add our spawner mono to it. Let's bop our spooky boy in there. And you need the aim of a Counter-Strike pro here. All right, push play. And let's hope and pray that our spooky boy shows up. And there he is, our spooky boy looking spooky as ever. And that's it. We got our spawner component, mono behavior and system all working together like a charm. We created our spooky boy prefab and spawned our boy into the field. There's nothing stopping us now. In the next video, we're going to be handling the input for our boy and getting him moving around, so it'll be great. If you have any comments or criticism on this, I would love to hear it in the comments below. And don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. It really helps out with my content. Thank you so much.